What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today we are going to install our operating system using a USB within the PowerEdge R620. I already inserted two flash drives in the back. The top USB right here is actually USB 1, and the bottom one is USB 2. The one in the bottom is where I'm going to install the operating system, and this is where I am going to boot the VMware ESXi operating system to start the installation, then pick this guy to install the operating system, and then configure the boot menu to boot out of this guy to boot inside the operating system, and then completely take advantage of all 8 drives for my storage, which I actually did a video with you guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy that video and configuring this as a RAID 10. So let's go inside the lifecycle controller and start the installation. All right, so we inserted our flash drives inside our PowerEdge R620. We are within our lifecycle controller. And from here, we are going to click on the OS deployment. We are going to click on Deploy OS. We have 5 steps to complete. On step 1, we have 2 options. One is to configure the RAID first or go directly to the OS deployment. Now, on the last video together, we configured the RAID configuration within the R620. We're going to pick on go directly to the OS deployment and then click on Next. On step 2, we need to select our operating system as well as pick our boot mode. This is really up to you. Click on the drop-down menu, pick your operating system, and then once you pick your operating system, it's going to start composing the OS drivers. Once that's done, you're going to click on Next and go to step 3. Now, in step 3, you have 2 options, which is the installation mode. You have unintended or manual install. Now, I'm going to pick manual install and then click on Next. And then select your OS media for step 4. Now again, I have 2 flash drives inserted inside the R620. So you gotta make sure you pick the right one. USB 1 is the one that I want to boot into. USB 2 is the one that I want to install the operating system into. Yeah. So click on that drop-down menu, pick the correct flash drive. And for me, it would be USB 1, okay? It's going to start validating the OS media. Once it's done, you're at step 5, which is reboot the system. Click on finish. You get this nice little informative dialog box. Once it's done, your machine's going to reboot and take you here. Awesome. Now, on this video together, we are going to install ESXi 6.5 on the R620. I'm going to hit enter to continue. It's going to start loading up the installer. It's going to continue loading everything up. Once all the loading is completed, it's going to take you here. You're going to click on enter, accept the license and terms, and just click on F11. It's going to start scanning all the available drives, and then bam, select the disk to install or upgrade. So again, it is going to be USB 2, and I like inserting flash drives with different names, because if you have the same flash drive, like for example, if you have like a 2 SanDisk, it's going to be confusing and picking. So that's the reason why I had like a SanDisk and then I had the Data Traveler. So what you're going to do from here is pick your flash drive where you want to install the operating system into. For this example, I am going to pick the SanDisk Ultra USB 3.0. And then I'm going to hit enter. It's going to start gathering additional information. Once completed, it's going to tell you this. I'm going to hit enter because I do want to wipe it clean. And boom, pick your keyboard layout, hit enter, enter your root password as well as confirm it and hit enter again. It's going to start gathering more information. It's going to prompt you the following, confirm the install. Yes, yeah, I want to install it. So press F11. It's going to start installing the ESXi 6.5 on the R620. Once it's done, you're going to get this. So we need to head over, remove that flash drive. Make sure you remove the correct flash drive. For me, it was USB 1, which was the top one. So we are going to remove that, come back, and then continue.
All right, so installation is completed. It wants me to remove the flash drive and then hit enter to reboot. So we're going to go to the back of the R620. This is the one I need to remove. Gotta use my fat fingers to get in there. There we go. Bam. Awesome. Put that to the side.
All right. So we remove the flash drive from the R620. We're back here. We're going to hit enter to reboot. It's going to start rebooting the machine.
Once it's done, what you want to do is get inside the BIOS, system setup. From here, we are going to pick on system BIOS, and we are going to click on boot setting. And within boot settings, we are going to click on BIOS boot setting. From here, we are going to go inside the hard disk drive sequence and just make sure you organize it to the point that the flash drive is going to be the primary hard drive that the R620 is going to boot into. So I made the modifications. I made the USB first and then the controller and then, you know, the flash media. Click OK. Click back. You're going to get this, hit yes for the changes. You're going to get a nice settings save successfully. Awesome. You're going to click on the exit button. And once you click on the exit button, you are going to get this nice little warning saying, are you sure you want to exit and reboot? Just hit yes for there. It's going to restart the machine and start loading up the VMware ESXi on the R620. And once everything is completed, bam, there you go. You're good to go. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up, smash that subscribe button. Also hit that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.